Today I'm going to be talking about perfume, more specifically how to make your perfume last longer. I have actually worked in a perfume store for a number of years in college, so I've learned a lot about perfume in that time, and I'm here to share with you some secrets that I've learned. And more specifically today, I'll be talking about how to make your perfume last longer. So the first thing you can do is make sure that you pick out the right formula for your nice smelling product. Now your nice smelling product comes in a couple different variations. There's the body spray, there's the eau de cologne, there is the eau de toilette, and then there's the eau de perfume, and then also there is the perfume oil. So there's a couple different levels of strength of the scent and also how long the scent will last. The perfume oil is the strongest concentrated formula. Now that's not something that you can find easily, and most companies don't actually make the perfume oil. It's like the syrup of the fragrance. Most typically, you'll be able to find the eau de perfume. That's the next best thing. That's typically something that most companies do produce. And it is gonna last you for about 4 to 6 hours in general. This is totally kind of generalizing everything, but typically it will last you 4 to 6 hours. And it has about 20% concentrate of that perfume oil to whatever alcohol, water, whatever they add to the total mixture. So the best thing you can do right off the bat is pick out the right formula, pick out the eau de perfume. If you can't find the eau de perfume, go for the eau de toilette, and then, you know, go for eau de cologne or the body spray if you can't find a higher option. Now, the more concentrated the formula is, the more expensive it's also going to be, so just keep that in mind. But I highly recommend going for the eau de perfume if you have that option. Some scents don't actually come in eau de perfume. For example, I don't believe Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue, which is one of the most popular scents for women, comes in eau de perfume. I might be wrong because I actually don't wear that scent, but I don't believe it does. At least I've never seen it come in eau de perfume. So that only comes in eau de toilette, and if you really like that scent, you have no other choice but wear eau de toilette. So that's one instance where you can't actually go for the eau de perfume, but typically just go for that. Now here I have one of my favorite perfumes. This is Juicy Couture Rivola Juicy. I have been wearing this perfume for a while, since high school in fact, and I still wear it today after college. I still think it smells good, and my boyfriend thinks it smells good as well, so and of course I'm gonna wear it. And on the bottom here it says, on the bottom here, if you can see, it says that it's eau de perfume. So on the bottom of your bottle, it should say whether it's an eau de perfume, eau de toilette, eau de cologne, or a body spray. It should indicate how strong the scent is inside the bottle there. Now another thing you can do also right off the bat when you buy your perfume is make sure you store it in the correct way. If you don't store your perfume in the correct way, the scent can change over time and the lasting power can also go down the drain. So you want to store it away from light, away from heat, and also away from damp areas. So in front of a window in a hot bathroom is a bad idea. You do not want to store it there. You typically want to store it in a drawer somewhere in a temperature controlled room. So that's another quick tip of how to store your perfume, because it is important and it is gonna impact the lasting power, and not only the lasting power but also the scent, because like I said, the scent can start to change and break down and start smelling rancid if you don't store your perfume in the correct way, because like anything, perfume can go bad and can get old. You just want to prevent that for as long as you possibly can. All right, so the next thing you can do is you can also spray your perfume in the best areas, those areas being the warmest and the most pulsating areas, basically where your pulse is. So that would be behind your ears. I also spray it in the back of my neck, because when my hair is down, especially if you have longer hair, your hair prevents the perfume from evaporating, and it only really lets the perfume escape when you move your head, and that's typically when you want your perfume to announce itself anyway. So I also spray it there. You can also spray it on your collarbone, your wrist, your elbow crease, your belly button, behind your knees, and your ankles. I know the belly button and behind your knees and your ankles, those are kind of the odd areas to spray your perfume, and those might be more appropriate if you live in like a warmer climate or if it's summertime. But I typically go ahead and spray my perfume behind the neck, kind of like around my neck basically. I try to go like this, and I also spray it on my wrists as well. The reason you want to spray it in those areas, the warmest and the most pulsating areas, is that the warmth and the pulsation will, I keep saying pulsation, kind of sounds weird but it's true, the warmth and the pulsation will actually make the perfume stronger. It will heat up the oils in the perfume and kind of push it out into the world. So you just want to make sure that you maximize the amount of strength and scent your perfume has to offer, and spraying it in those areas is the best way you can ensure that you're doing that. Another thing you can do, and this is a trick, is you can actually moisturize your skin before applying perfume. You can either have that be an excuse to moisturize your whole body or just moisturize the areas where you're going to be applying perfume. I typically do one or the other. The best thing you can do is actually use a scent-free fragrance if you really care about the scent of your perfume and you want to not disturb that in any way. But if you don't, you can use whatever lotion, potion you have at home. So this one right here, Eucerin Original Healing Cream, is a really good option. Obviously, I would just apply it in the area where I'm applying perfume, kind of around my neck. You can also use some Vaseline. This is my go-to for just quickly moisturizing a certain area and applying my perfume. And this does extend the length of your perfume for a while. So this is how I typically go for adding a little bit extra lasting power to my perfume. I go ahead and I take my Vaseline, and I'm gonna show you how I do it on my wrist, but I typically would also do it kind of around my neck as well. But this is how I do it on my wrist. I just go ahead and I apply a little bit of Vaseline on the wrist, just rub it in, apply a good amount so you have some product on your wrist but you don't have extra amount where if you place your wrist on a table you're not gonna be left with like a goopy stain on the table or anything like that. So once you have your Vaseline on your wrist or anywhere where you're applying your perfume, you take your perfume, my favorite, and you go ahead and you spray. It smells so good. Alright, so another thing you do not want to do is you do not want to rub your wrist together or rub the perfume once you apply it. This is because if you do that, if you do rub your wrist together or any other area, the perfume chemical composition, it starts to break down and the scent and the lasting power goes down the drain at that point. Not necessarily completely, but it does disintegrate a little bit, so you do not want to do it. Just don't go like this if you can avoid it. I know it's kind of instinctive, you just want to do that. I want to do that as well, but it's like popping pimples. You want to avoid doing that because if you do, you're gonna be much happier and left with much better results after that. So that is all of the tips I wanted to share with you today. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or comments, leave those down below. Also, while you're down there, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I left a sneaky little link down the bottom as well. Thank you so much for watching my video, and I will see you in the next one, and have an awesome day. Bye.